Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. It is Friday. Who does not like Fridays? It is sunny here in Seattle. Who does not like it being sunny? I got caught in the rain yesterday, which was not pretty when you're walking with groceries. Anyway, today we are talking Fenty Beauty. I went out this morning. I actually had another video for today. Went out this morning to get the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Instant Retouch Concealer. You guys know I love concealers. I love trying out new concealers too. And this is retails for $26. It comes with 0.27 ounces. And I believe it's like, what is it? She has 50 shade ranges, which is great. I got it in the shade 255, and let's talk about it. Yeah, it is a creamy long wear crease proof liquid concealer with light as air, medium to full coverage that brightens under eyes and conceals blemishes and redness, which is great. It is free of parabens and all that stuff, and it's cruelty free. So it is a medium to full coverage, so it's buildable. How to use: apply directly under the eyes or over blemishes and blend with the Precision Concealer Brush 180 or Little Precision Makeup Sponge Duo 105, each sold separately. I'm going to use my Artiste brush, which this is what I normally use to blend my concealer. And just for effect, I'm going to use the Beauty Blender, which a lot of people use to blend their concealer with. Rihanna's way: when brightening under eyes, let Pro Filter Concealer dry completely before setting with Pro Filter Instant Retouch Setting Powder, sold separately. Rihanna likes to set as the very last step in her makeup routine for the best results. Okay, I normally let my concealer sit for a bit as well, so that's good. All right, let's open it. It was interesting though, a fun fact, I asked the Sephora person, I said, oh, so have you tried it? And she goes, no, I haven't tried it. I was like, oh, has anyone in Sephora tried it? And she goes, well, actually, we weren't allowed to. I was like, oh. She goes, no, we weren't allowed to play with it or swatch it or anything. So the people who are coming in the store, this is the first time it's being swatched, so we don't know anything about it. I'm like, oh, okay. That was interesting. It's an interesting thing, but yeah. So I just said, oh, okay, let me go buy the concealer. You can't say anything after that because I don't know why they didn't let them play with it or swatch it or anything, but you know, so be it. So this is the same thing, shape kind of as her, not the shape, but the look of the foundation, and a white cap, see-through. I like the flat tip doe foot, and yeah, so it's not a, it's, yeah, that's glass. I think it's glass or plastic. That could be plastic, could be plastic. I think it's, no, that's plastic, I'm sorry. But anyway, it's just a, nothing fancy or anything of that nature. Let's give it a whirl, you know? That's what you're waiting on, so let's see. Okay. Oh, it goes on creamy. We're gonna just put a bit on, not a whole lot. And we're gonna let it set for a little bit because that's what I normally do. But this is a, it goes on creamy. Not overly thick, but yeah. So let's let it sit for a second. I normally let mine sit while I do my eyebrows, but I'm not necessarily doing my eyebrows today. I do have foundation on. I have my Dior foundation on, by the way. All right, I'm gonna blend it out with this, with my Artiste brush. I put mine over the lid as well. Even when I'm not wearing eyeshadow, I still do that. Okay, so that's one layer. Let's do another layer. Let's try with the Beauty Blender sponge. I have a damp Beauty Blender. Okay, so the medium coverage, yes. And this eye definitely looks like I put obviously something on it. But right in here, let me see if I can build this up to what my shape tape or even my, right now I'm loving that Charlotte Tilbury concealer. Oh my gosh. Let me let that dry a little bit. But yeah, I got the right color, which is great. 255 is for medium skin with very warm undertones. So I'm glad I got the right one. Because there is one for medium skin with warm undertones, which is 235. All right, let's blend this out. Let's get a little closer. Let me see. Okay, that's pretty. No, that's pretty. I think it's really pretty. It goes on nice and creamy, and does it give me the full coverage that my Tarte Shape Tape does? No, but it's still really pretty. It's a nice medium coverage. Let me set it with my, you guys know I've been loving this Beauty Bakery setting flower. It's amazing. But so you guys can see. I'm gonna let this sit underneath there a little bit and see. Hopefully it does not cake up. But yeah, no, this is pretty. It goes on nice and creamy, not too much sheen. And it's also not as thick as the Shape Tape. And the Shape Tape dries down a bit more, a bit faster. So no, this is a nice medium, to me, more of a medium coverage concealer. Yeah. All right, let's just kind of. I think this is a nice medium coverage concealer. The problem is that I still have darkness underneath here. And so medium to full coverage, I wouldn't call it full coverage for me who has lots of dark circles, but this probably will be full coverage for someone who doesn't have as deep dark circles as me. But no, I like the consistency. It's lovely. I like it. Yeah. So I hope that helps you guys when I said it. Did it catch in some of my lines? Yeah, but I have lines. Yeah. Or is it drying? No, I wouldn't say it's drying. No, I think it's a nice concealer. Yeah. This is my first impression of it. I haven't worn it all day, nothing like that. So if something changes, of course, you guys know I'll put an update for it. Yeah, so I hope this first impression helped you guys figure out if it's something that you want to try or not. But yeah, I like the consistency of it. I like that it goes on smooth and creamy, but it's not full coverage for me. So this is something I would probably use more like my Urban Decay Naked, which this is a little, this is more full coverage than that, but it doesn't go to the next level for me when I'm looking to really, I was about to say, conceal it up. I hope this helped you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have an amazing weekend, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.